before I start, I want to ask a question. Of course, I am few days, but I want to ask anyway. Anyone have a photogrammetric modeling experience before? Okay. Anyone faced with errors of the photogrammetric modeling? So do you like them or just get rid of them? Now you do 3D modeling? Or we just, yeah, okay.
Obviously, we tried to solve them, right? There were papers on that.
Yeah, of course, I have a huge background. Mostly we use photogrammetric modeling for documentation or simulation. So base things should be accurate and complete modeling, of course. So what if we use the errors of the modeling as a design approach, design methodology? So maybe we can have some result from them. So last year we organized a workshop under the Medeniyet City for Movie Image Static Space in Istanbul. So the title is Kill the Museum by Design. So it is a automation related, what does the title mean? So location we choose as a cultural heritage site in Istanbul near the historical peninsula is called Galata. And we choose as a cultural heritage site called Tophane Fountain. There was another structure, but we mostly focus on in the middle structures. So you can see the location in here. Fountain. So we use also some values, like one of them is the challenge as a water, because the fountain, especially during the autumn time in Istanbul, is a kind of, it has cultural values. Mostly people go there and chat and meet and then get some water, of course. But after the water system is changed, it lost its values and function. Also, we use a tool as image as a tool because the workshop is a part of a design research project in field of the digital heritage, and the project investigates digital means for participation in a process of cultural heritage making, and especially this presentation focuses on the characterize the glitches that occur as part of the photogrammetry process, which is the 3D modeling method. And the modeling process, there are several determinants of photogrammetric production, including brightness, transparency, which is element of the camera lens and shutter speed or other kind of shooting elements. Frequently, data determination from the 2D images to 3D objects change the message. Photographs are converted to 3D sculptures with errors, or as we call defined glitches, that appear like holes or dislocation of the pixel colors values. Such internal errors are potentially representative of a gap in knowledge where users must project their own conceptual understanding to complete it. So if I mention a little bit workflow, the workshop it has photogrammetric processing and interaction part. So we use, of course there's too many photogrammetric software, but we use, at that time it was Photoscan, but now Metasharing is sold, and also some of the 3D modeling, which is 3D's Max, Maya, also Blender. And then for interaction, we use Unity. So this centralizing of the artifacts from its materiality by tolerating the glitches of the digital transcoding processes leads us to evaluation of means of for stimulating the subjective performance of users, whereby emotion and intertextual narratives can be represented. Also, the workshop show how the issues are equated to rather than the catalyzed, the communication between the machine and human. So you can see some, this is the fountain itself. And also processing in photogrammetric software. So post-processing, there are many methods that we use for, if you talk about 3D modeling, they have some vertex and faces, which is, it has different numbers. If you change the numbers, there also occur some glitches on the 3D model. So this is, for example, number of the vertexes. So we changed the data numbers and then it became a glitch on the 3D modeling. So basically first we address the photogrammetric modeling, photogrammetric documentation process of historical site, and secondly demonstrate the interactive immersive environment used for its visualization, and finally explains the role of the glitch and user-generated content in the dissemination of its heritage value. So you can see some samples from. So we also put in the Unity. It became much more interactive. So we, as I remember, there's a challenge about the water. So it looks like a little bit fluid forms of the water. When we change the models, it creates a glitch. If I talk about the title means, of course, we don't try to kill the museum, but we try to create another, we try to create alternative way of to use cultural heritage. Because the idea of heritage and authenticity have been attributed to authorized institutions such as galleries and museums, but they demand for public participation, especially in museum, has created a rift in this situation. In contrast to the conventional way of the authenticity and aestheticism, in museum, contemporary mediums, or we can call also digital technologies, is more open for content generation by public and also individual storytelling. Of course, there is a despite the question about originality, authorship, and value, it is digital technology as an important area to develop new museum and heritage standards for long-standing ethical protocols such as authenticity. And also, authorized heritage institutions are traditionally organized as a product-oriented oriented design. So define ethical subjects such as authenticity and heritage values, as I mentioned before. But digital tools offer like new ways to understand these ethical considers, as well as the gain more practical insight from the user experience. So you can see also in workshop more practical user experience. So if I talk about a little bit about Fish project in terms of this concept, we create some digital platform we call Museum of Gamers. So we can see the so we give some courses which is about digital heritage and design. So students creating photogrammetric modeling, and they will create video games using that photogrammetric modeling. And then we create a tag page in Sketchpad, and there's a, we're using some tag, if you want, you can check it, Museum of Games, and Artuklay is the university town's called. So basically, they can much more communicate with the online form, and also they can communicate to their cultural values using this kind of digital technologies. Well, yeah, that's all I think. Thank you.